resume to be accessed by local and foreign job providers. In partnership with the DOT and DILG, information on all tourism spots can be aggregated in a single platform. The DICT is working closely with the DFA, DOT, and the Bureau of Immigration to implement the Philippine e-Visa portal for easier entry of tourists into the country. In partnership with the Bureau of Quarantine, Bureau of Immigration, Bureau of Customs, Department of Health, Department of Tourism, and Department of Transportation, multiple outbound and inbound travel declarations and health forms are unified under the Philippine One-Stop Electronic Travel Declaration System. Your feedback plays a crucial role in enhancing governance and fulfilling the government's mandate. You can now register your SIM card in the EGOV-PH Super App. Be updated on the current events and developments in the nation with the Government App News through the Presidential Communications Office. You can now have your digital PhilSys ID and securely and confidently store your government-issued IDs inside the app. In partnership with the LTO, Filipinos may now have a copy of their digital driver's licenses, accessed and securely stored under the digital government ID wallet. What are you waiting for? Download EGOV-PH now, available in Play Store and in App Store. The Philippines in one single app. Conveniently access government service online. Avoid long lines, face-to-face, and paper-based transactions. Introducing the EGOV-PH Super App. It is the Philippines' first one-stop-shop platform for local and national government services that will streamline processes and transactions and bring a total ease of doing business to all Filipinos. E-government priority projects can also be integrated, like job creation, travel, investments, agriculture, and e-commerce. E-government services from both national and local governments can also be featured. The DICT signed Memoranda of Understanding with 26 government agencies. The fast and secure digital process for identity verification without the required physical documents or face-to-face interaction. The verification process is powered by eGov AI with electronic Know Your Customer or EKYC capability. Using the eGov EKYC, a national digital ID can be generated via the Philippine Statistics Authority PhilSys integration. A one-stop-shop app feature that allows you to access all national government services, powered by single sign-on. It essentially provides Filipinos with access to an online one-stop-shop that offers a variety of LGU services, such as applying for clearances, certifications, and permits. In partnership with DOLE, CHED, TESDA, and other agencies, citizens can now build their simple resume to be accessed by local and foreign job providers. In partnership with the DOT and DILG, information on all tourism spots can be aggregated in a single platform. The DICT is working closely with the DFA, DOT, and the Bureau of Immigration to implement the Philippine e-Visa portal for easier entry of tourists into the country. In partnership with the Bureau of Quarantine, Bureau of Immigration, Bureau of Customs, Department of Health, Department of Tourism, and Department of Transportation, multiple outbound and inbound travel declarations and health forms are unified under the Philippine One-Stop Electronic Travel Declaration System. Your feedback plays a crucial role in enhancing governance and fulfilling the government's mandate. You can now register your SIM card in the EGOV-PH Super App. Be updated on the current events and developments in the nation with the Government App News through the Presidential Communications Office. You can now have your digital PhilSys ID and securely and confidently store your government-issued IDs inside the app. In partnership with the LTO, Filipinos may now have a copy of their digital driver's licenses, accessed and securely stored under the digital government ID wallet. What are you waiting for? Download EGOV-PH now, available in Play Store and in App Store. The Philippines in one single app. Conveniently access government service online. Avoid long lines, face-to-face, and paper-based transactions. Introducing the EGOV-PH Super App. It is the Philippines' first one-stop shop platform for local and national government services that will streamline processes and transactions and bring a total ease of doing business to all Filipinos. E-government priority projects can also be integrated, like job creation, travel, investments, agriculture, and e-commerce. E-government services from both national and local governments can also be featured. The DICT signed Memoranda of Understanding with 26 government agencies. The fast and secure digital process for identity verification without the required physical documents or face-to-face interaction. The verification process is powered by eGov AI with electronic Know Your Customer or EKYC capability. Using the eGov EKYC, a national digital ID can be generated via the Philippine Statistics Authority PhilSys integration. A one-stop shop app feature that allows you to access all national government services, powered by single sign-on. It essentially provides Filipinos with access to an online one-stop shop that offers a variety of LGU services, such as applying for clearances, certifications, and permits. In partnership with DOLE, CHED, TESDA, and other agencies, citizens can now build their simple resume to be accessed by local and foreign job providers. In partnership with the DOT and DILG, information on all tourism spots can be aggregated in a single platform. The DICT is working closely with the DFA, DOT, and the Bureau of Immigration to implement the Philippine e-Visa portal for easier entry of tourists into the country. In partnership with the Bureau of Quarantine, Bureau of Immigration, Bureau of Customs, Department of Health, Department of Tourism, and Department of Transportation, multiple outbound and inbound travel declarations and health forms are unified under the Philippine One-Stop Electronic Travel Declaration System. Your feedback plays a crucial role in enhancing governance and fulfilling the government's mandate. You can now register your SIM card in the EGOV-PH Super App. Be updated on the current events and developments in the nation with the Government App News through the Presidential Communications Office. You can now have your digital PhilSys ID and securely and confidently store your government-issued IDs inside the app.
We are pleased to welcome you to the press conference of the Philippine Statistics Authority and the Department of Information and Communications Technology for the launch of the Digital National ID, National ID E-Verify, and National ID Check today, June 10, 2024. I'm Nikita Bea, your moderator for this press conference. We would like to note that this event is being live-streamed on the PSA and PhilSys Facebook pages. So for today's press conference, to further discuss the three products launched by the PSA in collaboration with DICT today, it is my honor to introduce to you our spokespersons for the launch of the Digital National ID, National ID E-Verify, and National ID Check. Let us all welcome National Statistician and Civil Registrar General Undersecretary Claire Dennis S. Mapa of the Philippine Statistics Authority and Undersecretary David Almirol Jr. of the Department of Information and Communications Technology. We would also like to recognize the presence of different officials coming from the PSA and the DICT who are both with us on site and virtually. Now, let us hear a few words from PSA Undersecretary Claire Dennis S. Mapa.
Good morning. Salamat sa pagdalo sa ating press conference para sa National ID, National ID Verify at National ID Check. Today, we make another step towards digitalization with the launch of our national digital national ID along with its authentication methods, the National ID E-Verify and the National ID Check. Para sa higit na 87 million Pilipino matagumpay na nakapag-register, nandito na ang National ID. Ang kailangan lang natin ay i-access ito online para magamit. This collaboration between the Philippine Statistics Authority and the Department of Information and Communication Technology, nandito yung aking kasama, si Yusik Dave, and we are very thankful to the support of DICT. Is a fulfillment of our shared goal towards Makabagong Pilipinas, where services are delivered efficiently and securely through digitalization. With this development, every registered Filipino now has access to a reliable and secure proof of identity that can be easily authenticated on their devices. This will facilitate the faster distribution and wider utilization of our national ID, with relying parties finding it easier to onboard to the national ID system. Ang target natin ay i-register lahat ng mga Pilipino sa national ID system. Mayroon pa tayong substantial portion of the population na hindi nare-registro at kami na nag-anyaya sa kanila na magpa-register sa ating mga registration centers para magamit na talaga nila yung national ID, lalo na mayroon na tayong digital national ID. Maraming salamat at magandang umaga sa ating lahat.
Thank you very much, Undersecretary Mapa, for that message. Now let us proceed with our open forum. Now before this juncture, we would like to extend our heartfelt thanks to all our press and media partners with us in our conference today. To ensure a smooth open forum, here are some reminders. Now for our online participants, you may raise the hand, you may use the raise hand feature of Zoom if you wish to ask our resource persons a direct question. When called upon to ask a question, please state your name and the organization you belong to before asking your question. You may also send questions via the chat box. Just make sure to include your name and the organization you belong to. Now, please keep your mics muted if you're not yet called to ask a question. For on-site participants, simply raise your hand if you have a question and wait to be acknowledged before asking. When called upon to ask a question, again, please state your name and your organization. For the copies of the press kits, we will send them to our online participants via email and Viber. Meanwhile, printed copies of the press kits will also be handed by our staff to our on-site media participants. Now, let's start with the first question, please. Coming from our advance invitation on questions that may be accommodated in this open forum. So for the first question, what was the compelling reason for the issuance of the digital ID?
I'll start, and then I will ask my partner here, Yusik Dave, to explain in greater detail. Of course, the digital national ID version is part of our effort, no? Whole of government efforts spearheaded by PSA and the DICT towards digitalization. Talagang yung instruction kasi sa amin ng Pangulo ay i-accelerate itong digitalization process. And para sa Philippine Statistics Authority and the National ID System, ito yung nakikita namin na paraan, no, para ma-accelerate itong ating digitalization process. But I will ask Yusek Dave to expound also on this.
Yes, good morning. The digital national ID is actually new, no? This is also the direction of other countries. So we also check what are the other countries doing. At actually, nahuli na tayo. Ano? At take note that Pilipinas, makita natin na we are very digitalized in terms of social media, di ba? Tayo tinawag na Facebook capital sa buong mundo. Nung nagkaroon ng text message, naging text capital sa buong mundo tayo. At I think we have a very good chance to cope up. The digital ID is not just to issue a national ID to the citizen digitally para kahit sa cellphone na lang, pwede nang ma-access ang kanilang mga national ID. Kundi ni-ready din natin yung mga napakadaming mga use cases, yung mga integration. Kasi hindi lang naman po basta may national ID eh. Talagang kailangan magamit. Kailangan ma-automate yung napakadaming mga government agency na mga paulit-ulit na ginagawa. So I think the digital national ID, the main purpose here is to really streamline and also do multiple simplification sa mga government at private transactions moving forward.
Thank you very much, Yusek Mapa and Yusek Dave. That was from Ms. Eileen Menchas of Abante News. Now we have additional questions from Ms. Eileen and Mr. Lance Mexico, journalist, on the status of the physical cards of the national ID. So how is the DSP addressing the delay in the delivery, and can we have an update on the schedule of deliveries of the physical ID card? When can we expect these to be finished?
Okay, sa ngayon ang datos natin ano in terms of the delivery. So first we'll start with the registration. So as of end of May, May 31, 2024, we registered about 87.6 million Filipinos. Of course, mayroon siyang proseso na dinadaanan. Yung una ay kailangan nating i-check for deduplication, no, yung authentic, yung person na yun utilizing the biometric. Ang pumasa na doon ay about 83.6 million. These are individuals that were provided already with the PhilSys, the unique PhilSys number. So they are clear for printing. Ang na-print out of the 83.6 million ay about 51.6 already delivered to the citizens. So 83.6 yung cleared na registrant, and we were able to deliver about 51.6 million. So admittedly, may backlog tayo rito ng mga 32 million. At while tuloy-tuloy ang pag-print ng physical cards sa Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas printing facility, that's why nandito yung digital national ID, kasi pwede na kaagad makapag-download ang 32 million individuals and even those with the physical card para makuha nila yung digital national ID. The PSA is committed to still print and deliver the physical card because that is the instruction to us by the President. Of course, mayroon tayong delay sa printing, and while we are doing it, we should not stop the use of the national ID, and that is the one of the reasons why we are launching this digital national ID. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now we have another question from Mr. Erlo Brines of Net25. Ano po ang assurance for the public na hindi po ito ma-hack or ma-compromise? The different products that we launched today. Yusek Alvaro, maybe
yeah.
You can
tell me. Yes, so the data is actually being managed by PSA, no? So ang maganda sa PSA, they have a so-called zero trust policy. So, encrypted yung kanilang data. Even us, nung ginawa ko natin po yung digital national ID, even us as integrator, wala kaming makita na data. So, this is how prepared and secured yung ano yung sistema. Ano. And the good news also with the digital national ID ay naka-full encrypt po lahat ng mga ito. Ano. Both internal and external attack, wala pong mangyayari kasi naka-zero trust policy tayo. Ibig sabihin, aside sa cybersecurity, of course we have to fortify that, but the data itself is unreadable, no, to the accessing entity, even programmers. So ganun kaganda po yung pagkakagawa ng security ng ating national ID, including yung ating digital national ID.
Vulnerability of a user from cyber hacking. So maybe
Well, when we spoke to different countries, how they are able to implement their digital IDs well, cybersecurity is their a priority. That's why ang ginawa ng PSA ay talagang ginawa nilang best practice yung pagkakagawa ng kanilang mga servers, including yung mga APIs nila. So ang ginawa naman ng DICT as ni-ready ito para magkaroon ng malawakang integration. So in fact, ang PSA po ang tumutulong para magkaroon ng simplification ng iba-ibang mga ahensya. Pero syempre, kanya-kanya pong mag-manage ng kanilang datos ng bawat isa. Kasi integration lang po yung pwedeng i-provide. In fact, hindi po nagbibigay ng dato directly ang PSA sa mga or DICT sa mga gagamit sa mga relying party. So they will be given an API, yung pinesend kanina ng PSA, na once na may access na sila sa e-verify.gov.ph, ay through API lang ang kanilang magagawa. Ibig sabihin, ay wala po talagang tinatawag na direct sharing of information. So integration po yung mangyayari dito. So ang in terms of cybersecurity naman, kanya-kanya pong mag-alaga ng bawat isa ng kanilang mga datos. Kasi at the end of the day, wala na pong control ang DICT or PSA sa mga respective na gumagamit, okay, ng ating national ID moving forward. Kasi ang bibigay lang talaga ng system ay yung verification lang, yung verification system.
Thank you, Yusek Dave. Yusek Dennis, would you have anything?
On the challenges, na explain na ni Yusek Dave yung process, no, yung to secure the database. Of course, the challenges that we are encountering moving forward. First, we want our citizens to download the digital national ID version. That's a priority. As I've said, one is that kailangan nating mabigyan, no, ng national ID yung ating mga kababayan na nirehistro na pero nag-aantay sila ng kanilang physical card. That is our priority. May mga datos naman ng PSA kung saan ito ng mga probinsya at ito yung aming ika-campaign, ano, na mag-download sila ng digital national ID. Ang isa rin naming when I say challenges, of course, I mentioned kanina, 87.6 million Filipinos are already registered to the national ID, but of course we have a population of 113 million ang projected population natin itong July 2024. So mayroon pa tayong mga balance na mga 25 million Filipinos, 26 million. So ito yung aming nire-register ngayon. Karamihan dito yung mga 0 to 4. Important na marehistro muna yung kanilang parents, no, bago sila marehistro. Ang 0 to 4 natin, ang population natin dyan ay about mga nasa 10 to 11 million. So a substantial under coverage, kumbaga, na hindi pa natin narehistro ay yung 0 to 4. So ito yung mga tinitingnan namin, ang ino-operate ng ating mga provincial offices. We are doing right now mobile registration. We are partnering with the barangay health centers para makita or mahanap namin, no, yung ating mga 0 to 4 year old, kasama of course yung parents and guardians, so that they can be registered to the national ID system and enjoy the benefits of having a national ID. Thank you.
Thank you, Enes Dennis. Now we have a question from our participant here. Yes, ma'am.
Hello, good morning. Sheila Francisco from TV5. My question is focus on mga challenges po. Una po, you mentioned 32 million have yet to receive their physical ID. And we know some of the marginalized sectors ay mga dekipad po yung phone, hindi po nakaka-act. Especially nagagamitin to for the financial inclusion and pagkuha ng mga social welfare services. Thank you.
Ang good news po sa national ID e-verify na nilaunch natin ngayon ay meron po siyang tatlong functionality, no. Unang-una, you can present the physical card na yung pong inisyu po ng ng PSA. Pangalawa ay yung kung meron kang digital na sa cellphone mo na. Pangatlo ay pwede mo nang i-present yung sarili mo na ikaw lang. So itong tawag po yung cardless verification system. So example po, we are doing integration with the DSWD kasi syempre yung mga farmers minsan wala talagang cellphone, walang internet sa kanilang lugar. Pero basta nakaregister na po sila sa PSA, guaranteed po sila na mabiverify po ng ating national ID e-verify. Sa kasalukuyan po ngayon, as of today, doon po sa 87 million po na nakapag-register na po sa PSA, meron na po tayong nasa 74 million na ready for the digital national ID. So ang kailangan lang po dito ay, of course, importante din sana na makapag-download sila sa kanilang cellphone kung meron. Pero kung wala man, ipresenta na din sarili nila. Okay, so it's called the cardless verification system. Ginagawa na po ito sa ibang bansa. In fact, yung mga ibang banko natin ngayon, kung mapapansin nyo po, naka-cardless verification system na rin po yung iba sa kanila. So, ang gobyerno po ay moving to that direction also. Pero maganda rin talaga na, of course, pag nakapag-distribute na ito ng physical, at least may hawak-hawak talaga. Kasi yung ownership, importante din talaga na may hawak-hawak siyang, which is, as mentioned by USEC MAPA, that they are doing their best to finish the distribution naman of the physical ID.
Sir, my other question is, paano po kunwari, kasi diba tatlo po yan, may national ID, ay digital ID, check, tsaka i-verify. May mga times po kasi diba po, hindi po nababasa yung QR code or down po yung website. So how do we address that also?
Actually, yung sinasabi ko, kapag ginamit po yung national ID i-verify, halimbawa po si DSWD o kaya si PhilHealth o kaya yung bangko, ginamit po yung API ni national ID i-verify, hindi na po kinakailangan. Of course, may QR code scanning pa din yon, pero just in case na sira yung QR code or hindi ma-scan yung QR code, yung tinatawag po na just show yourself technology, ito po yung makabago ngayon sa digital na mundo. Ibig sabihin, pag nag-enter yung first name, last name, middle name, birthday, at nag-fingerprint ka o kaya nag-face recognition ka, mabiverify nga na, ikaw nga pala si Juan de la Cruz. Kung nakapag-download na po kayo ng eGov app, napansin ninyo na hindi kayo nag-submit ng any ID, but you're able to register kasi yun po yung power po ng National ID e-verify.
Sir, offline siya, yung app na yun, yung e-verify app. Pwedeng offline gawin. Kasi
hindi, hindi po. So, doon po sa offline, hindi talaga po ma-access. Yung pong relying party, kailangan po siyang online. Pero syempre, kung may physical card ka, po pwede na bang pong offline. Mm-hmm. Ayan, so...
Yun, sir. Kasi diba, syempre, may mga iba po, minsan talagang, kunyari, sinasira yung internet or... So how do we address po?
Meron po yung QR code po, no? Yung pong ginawa ng physical card ng ng PS. Maganda po yung pagkakagawa ng physical card kasi po kahit na typical na camera lang na walang cellphone, pwede pong i-verify. Kahit wala pong internet, mabe-verify po 'yon.
Yun kanina yung isa sa tatlo na ni-launch natin yung National ID Check. Pwedeng ma-verify yung QR code, no? Siguro idagdag ko lang, Shaira. Well, of course, we want, no, and we will encourage talaga the citizens to start downloading itong ating digital national ID version. But if you recall, and it was discussed also during the launch kanina, as I mentioned, we already distributed 51.6 million physical card. But mayroon tayong dinistribute din na mga e-fill ID. Ang e-fill ID number is about nasa 46 million. So ang aming assessment is that Filipinos have either the physical card or the e-fill ID card, and we want that they will also have access to this digital national ID. And kanina itong mga systems natin ay nababasa niya yung QR code, no, kung ikaw man ay may hawak ng physical card, e-fill ID or the digital national ID. Thank you.
All right, we have another question.
Hello po, good morning. I'm Jervis Manahan of ABS-CBN. So my question is, as we speak, there's quite a lot of feedback saying na there are a lot of agencies that are not yet accepting the digital national ID. So what do we tell them? Like, are we working towards acceptance ng ID na to sa mga like SSS, NBI?
Yeah. Using Dave, yung Philippine Statistics Authority kasi kami yung implementing agency naman, ano. Of course may mga birth pains tayo dyan, and we are addressing it. First is that we issued already a memorandum to our outlets, no? Kasi alam niyo sa CRS outlet, yun talaga yung isa sa mga gumagamit ng ating national ID. So whether this physical card, the e-fill ID, or the digital national ID, we issued an advisory informing our public and the relying parties that the digital national ID shall be a sufficient proof for identity and age, subject of course to proper authentication. So ito naman yung mga process na ginagawa natin. Nung lumabas yung mga yung una nating physical card, nagkaroon tayo ng ganitong concerns. Talagang ganun yan kasi bago eh. But the Philippine Statistics Authority and the DICT, together with our partners, Office of the President will issue advisories on the use of the digital national ID. Kasi kung ginagamit mo yung, kung di natanggap mo na yung PhilID, there's no reason why you should not accept the digital national ID. Pareho lang talaman ang information na nandun. Thank you.
Yung follow-up question po is, pinapatanong lang, no? Dati apparently may mga nag-apply before na nakakuha sila nung digital version, yung piniprint at nilalaminate. Ano daw po ang difference nito dito sa nilaunch natin ngayon?
They can still use it, but of course, itong digital national ID version as presented will have more uses, for example, through our eGov app. But all of these three versions, no, yung physical card, yung e-fill ID, and the digital national ID can be used for transactions. Yusik Dave, you want to add on that?
Yes, I think ang maganda rin dun sa bagong nilaunch ng PSA at DICT ay hindi lang yung basta lang may bigay ka na ID, no? Kasi normally ganyan yung focus natin. Oh, ako si David Almirol or si Juan de la Cruz. Pero itong ginawa nga na ngayon ng PSA at DICT, the moment na binigay mo yung ID at QR code yan or enter yung PCN number mo, meron siyang full automation. Ibig sabihin, mawawala na ang mga forms ng government. So imagine, pupunta ka later on sa iba-ibang ahensya, di ba? Kailangan ka mag-physical presence doon. And you have to go there to magpi-fingerprint ka na naman ulit, tama? Magpi-picture taking ka na naman ulit, kaya mahaba yung pila. So yung automation process, ito po yung na-ready ngayon ng PSA at DICT using the National ID E-Verify.
Thank you very much, Yusek Dave, for that. Yes, sir? A question from the... All right.
Hi, sir. Clay Paul from PTV4. Sir, tanungin ko lang po kung kailan po target maibigay lahat ng physical copies this year po ba? Thank you.
Sa ngayon, yung ating, as I've said, no, mayroon tayong 51.6 million na physical card na distribute. Currently, yung ating partner, yung PhilPost, no, ay nag-distribute ng another 3 million cards. So, while the 51.6 million ay nandun na sa mga registrants natin, yung 3 million ay to be distributed. We will continue, no? The PSA naman is committed to print and deliver all these cards. But as I've said, while you don't have the physical card, you have this digital national ID that you can already download and start using it. Kasi hindi mo naman kailangan na yung physical card para makapag-transact ka ng, sa government or private sector, the digital national ID is sufficient. But we will be delivering it, no? Doon sa mga registrants natin na register na, and those that will be registered. The President instructed us to continue delivering the physical card.
Sir, sorry to push the question, pero this year naman po, mabibigay lang.
Marami ang makukover natin ngayong taon, pero kasi nagdadagdag. Una kasi mas mabilis ang pag-download ng digital national ID kasi yung pag-print ng card, no? Kasi syempre may machine yon, may limit tayo dyan sa pag-print. So the digital national ID would be faster in terms of downloading compared to the physical card.
My last question is, meron po ba tayong regions kung saan yung medyo mababa yung registrants?
We will have data on that. We can provide later on. Mayroon tayong percentage kasi yung aming basehan diyan, yung registered versus their projected population. So we have that data. Thank you.
Another question from our participant here on site. Yes, sir.
Hi, good morning, Dan. Ating Kungko of GMA 7. I have a couple of questions. Just ano lang, for the record, what have been the challenges dun sa physical printing? I understand may parang reference kayo. You made a reference to like machine, there's a limit, and also you made references din kanina to PhilSys, yung mga nabigyan ng PhilSys, yung mga na-verify yung biometrics. Would we consider that as yung factors why hindi lahat? Or meron pang ibang challenges to be considered? Bakit hindi pa nade-deliver lahat ng mga physical ID?
Okay, yung process natin sa end-to-end, no? From registration to delivery, of course, it starts on the registration process. Kailangan nating i-register. So ito yung kanina sabi ko, mga 87.6 million. Pagkatapos noon, kailangan talagang i-verify sila in terms of their biometrics, no, demographic and biometrics, para malaman natin kung mayroon tayong duplicates, no. So they go through the process of what we call deduplication. So yun ang isa. Ang iba dito sa ating mga kababayan ay napa-flag doon sa deduplication. Ibig sabihin, mayroon siyang may probability na mayroon siyang ka-duplicate. So that's part, hindi yun magpo-proceed. So tinitingnan ng mga teams natin sa Fraud Management Division, whether ito ba ay talagang pareho. So may process yun. This is part of our quality checks that we're doing. And then once na ma-clear ka, mabibigyan ka ng tinatawag na PhilSys number, that's the unique number, and then you go through the printing na doon sa ating printing facilities ng Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas. Sa ngayon, with the digital national ID, doon tayo kukuha nung pwede na mag-download yung may mga tinatawag nating unique national ID number. So they can already download that. Sa ating printing facilities, of course, sabi ko nga, may limit ang ating printing, no? Because there are steps also from the time na matanggap yung data and the printing. So the maximum number of cards that can be printed on a given day is 80,000 cards, no? And depending on conditions, minsan mababa ito. Pero sabi ko nga, unlike the downloaded national ID, you can download in a way hundreds of thousands or millions. So mabilis siya compared sa printing. So those are the challenges on the printing side.
Follow up corollary to that. Is it correct to say, ano lang, I'll just play devil's advocate. Tama bang sabihin na yung digital national ID is just a stopgap measure na, okay, habang hindi pa napiprint lahat, ito muna? Or is it something that is meant to complement? Or is it something that is meant to replace? I understand may references kayo na ginawa dyan, pero for the record, let's just set the record
straight. I'll just quickly answer it and then Music Dave will explain. Yung hindi ito yung stopgap, ano? Kasi sabi nga, yung lahat ng mga pwedeng gawin ng physical card ay kayang gawin at mas marami pa dito sa ating digital national ID. And if you look at, I mentioned ni Yusik Dave, if you look at other countries, they are actually not releasing the physical card but utilizing the digital version or the digital national ID. So we are actually moving towards digitalization. Yusik Dave?
Yes, so as mentioned kanina, hindi lang natin po inimbento, no, itong digital national ID. So we had a lot of references. Example for South Korea, they are really moving into full digital national ID na sila. Ngayon, pag walang physical, they can just show themselves. Di ba? Kasi nga, the system can still verify them. So it's, I think mindset also is very important, no, that we need to change the mindset. Na minsan kasi, ang kala natin is pag may physical card ka, ito lang yung dahil may national ID. Dapat ang mindset ng ating mga mamamayan ngayon, naka-register na ako sa PSA. Ako ay rehistrado na ng PSA. So regardless kung anong hawak mo, mayroon ka mang physical, mayroon ka mang digital, or yung dala mo yung sarili mo. In fact, kahit na ibang ID ang isubmit, halimbawa, kahit senior citizens ID ang isubmit, PWD, yung system kayang i-verify pa din yan, gamit pa rin ng national ID i-verify. So I think ito yung challenges na ibang bansa, no, yung adoption, yung understanding. Kasi akala nila is magkaiba ang physical saka digital. Pero isa lang naman po ang pinanggalingan po ng sistema, PSA lang naman pinanggalingan ng sistema. So I think we need also to start educating our fellow mamamayan na walang pinagkaiba ang physical at digital. Yung ibang bansa, in fact, ang priority nila is digital. Pero kung gusto nilang magkaroon ng physical, pwede silang kumuha ng physical. Pero ang ganda po ng ginagawa ng ating PSA ngayon, kasi kahit na may digital ka na, ang maganda kasi hindi naman lahat marunong mag-digital, 'di ba? Sa mga liblib na lugar, 'di ba? Maganda rin na may hawak-hawak na physical. So tuloy-tuloy naman po yung pag-aano. Alam ko yung challenges kasi yung printing, hindi po biro din po 'yun, no. May mga prosesong dinadaanan. But the physical and digital, hindi po to stopgap, no. Kung anong gamit mo, physical man or digital, national ID pa din po yan. Walang pinagkaiba.
My last question would be yung user case, yung binabanggit ninyo, because I understand kanina meron ng apat na banks and one financial institution na basically nagsabi na on board na sila. So as we announce the National Digital ID today, what can the public expect? Like, saan nila pwedeng gamitin from today as we speak? Ano yung scenarios? Where can they use it? And where can they not yet use it? Saan nila magagamit ito ngayon? And saan nila to pwedeng gamitin pa na pwede nilang asahan in the future?
May mga time na hindi nila napapansin na nagagamit na pa nila. So example po, pumunta po sa isang banko, no? At yung banko meron siyang online banking at nag-apply siya. Doon dahil ginamit niya po yung National ID E-Verify at naglagay siya, nag-apply siya ng isang account sa isang online banking, naglagay ng first name, last name, middle name, birthday at nag-selfie po siya doon, hindi niya namalaya na kahit hindi siya nag-submit ng kanyang ID, na verify na siya gamit po ng National ID E-Verify. So wala siyang sinabit at all. Kasi we're trying to cut the mentality na, ay kapag di ko pinakita yung National ID ko, hindi ako na-verify. Kaya po, digital na po tayo eh. So meron tayong tinatawag po na contactless registration. Sa ibang mga government agency naman po, ito po yung pangarap natin po, ano, na ginagawa din ng napakaraming ahensya ngayon. Di ba, kung napansin ho ninyo, if you go to other agency, you have to submit multiple documents or you have to give again your first name, your last name, your middle name, then magbigay ka pa ng ID mo. Ngayon, hindi na. Pag pumunta ka sa isang agency, physical man or online, at binigay mo yung information mo, let's say ako po si David Almirol, ito po yung birthday ko, at nag-fingerprint ako, yung agency, hindi na siya mag-e-encode pa ng data. Automatic na yon. Hindi na rin siya mag-fingerprint ulit. Di ho ba? Hindi na rin po siya mag-submit ulit ng another ID na i-scan pa yon or pipicturan pa. So these are some of the live use case po na ano natin, nagawa natin. Example po, ano, si PhilHealth, as I checked this morning, meron silang 1.2 million use case na sila sa National ID E-Verify. So lahat ng mga nagkakaroon po ng registration sa bagong PhilHealth system ngayon, hindi na kinakailangan pang mag-submit ng any document. So aasahan po ng mamamayan na ang National ID, basta sila ay rehistrado ng PSA, magagamit na po yung kanyang National ID. Hindi lang yung dahil kailangan mo pang i-present. So we cut a bureaucracy there. Yung mindset kasi na kailangan mong ipakita yung ID mo para ma-prove na may National ID ka. Hindi. The moment na nag-apply ka sa isang sistema ng private man or government, gamit ng National ID, mapuprove na nga ikaw ngayon. Yan po yung ating implementation po sa use cases.
Thank you, Yusek Dave. Yusek Dennis, would you want to add?
Yung ating National ID, yung form ng physical, e-ID, and the digital, tinatanggap na ito sa mga banko, ano? Pag nag-open ka ng bank accounts, for example, remittance centers, ito ay tinatanggap na. In fact, sa GCash, pag nag-open ka ng GCash account, yung mga partners natin sa GCash ay nandito kasama natin sa launch. So ito yung mga ibang private sector. Sa government naman talagang ginagamit na ito. We are using it to authenticate, for example, yung ating DSWD beneficiaries para maiwasan yung mga leakages. So while we launched this, the PSA together with the ICT has been already working behind the scene to make sure that government agencies and private sectors are using it. And with the launch of the Digital National ID, our expectation is that the usage will be accelerated, lalo na sa private sector. Thank you,
Yusek Dennis. Now, at this point, we can now only accommodate the last three questions. So for those questions that we cannot accommodate, online participants may send their questions via the Zoom chat and we will answer offline, and on-site participants may approach our registration booth where the PSA staff will take note of your questions. Now, for the last few questions here on-site, yes, Sir Jervis.
Hi again, I'm Jervis again from ABS-CBN. So, sir, yung website na sinabi kanina, yung thenational.id.gov.ph, this is only for people who have already registered. Yes. Tama po ba? Yes. So, ibig sabihin, if I have not registered at all, this will not work.
Yeah. Pero wala namang problema kasi we have about 2,000 registration centers all over the country. At ang kailangan lang, pumunta ka, mayroon kami sa lahat ng mga PSA provincial offices. Mayroon tayong registration. Madali na lang yung registration ngayon kasi una, marami na tayong na-rehistro. And then we have also in certain malls. And in fact, we have mobile registration sa barangay. So very important, yun yung kanina sinasabi ko, very important na mag-register muna. And then from there, once ma-clear na no, yung ating process, you can download the national ID digital. Thank you.
Thank you. The last, second to the last question before we accommodate the another question from our online. Yes.
Hello po. I just like to clarify. You have the national ID check and the national ID e-verify. Hindi ba po redundant or bakit hindi na lang po pinag-isa total parehong verification system? Thank you.
Ang pinagkaiba po ng national ID check at national ID e-verify, yung national ID e-verify po kasi automation ang kayang i-provide niyan. So kapag ginamit po ito ng bangko o ginamit ng mga government agency, wala nang papel-papel sa kanila. Wala nang form later on. Kahit online na lang, kahit yung Pilipino nasa bahay na lang, pwede na silang kumuha ng mga government transaction services. Yung national ID check naman, ay wala siyang integration. So ito po yung, halimbawa, nag-submit ng physical sa eskwelahan. E sa eskwelahan, wala siyang time na mag-integrate sa e-verify. So pwede niyang puntahan yung national ID check para i-check nga kung totoo yung kanyang ID. So it's just isa sa physical checking na totoo nga siya versus yung tao na ano niya, na nakakasalamuhan niya. National ID e-verify is more, ito po yung pinupush din po natin po ngayon na pag nagamit po ito ng lahat ng government agency later on, imagine po yung impact nito, yung simplification na magagawa sa mga government systems natin, pati sa private. Yeah.
Thank you, Yusek Dave. Yusek Dennis, do you want to add anything? Okay. For the last question coming from our online participant, what is the timeline of the government in harmonizing or standardizing the data in each government agency? This is coming from NNA Philippines. So, Yusek Dave, thank you.
Alam mo ninyo, as a programmer myself, ito po yung isang hinahangad natin no, na magkaroon ng streamlining sa proseso, hindi pa ulit-ulit. Pero yung foundation kasi ng innovation or digitalization napaka-importante. At ang isa sa pundasyon talaga ng innovation ng isang bansa ay ang national ID. So kapag ito ay kapag itong foundation na to ay solid na nandiyan na, isa si national ID sa tinatawag na foundational technology ng ating bansa. So lahat ng i-build on top of it, makikinabang ang pangkalahatan. So the national ID e-verify, yung ating digital national ID, pati yung physical ID natin, ito po ay para magkaroon ng data entering modules ng mga government agency. Garbage in, garbage out po kasi ang nangyayari po eh. Kapag mali yung pinasok, mali hanggang dulo. Pero ang national ID, kapag ito ang pinasok, 100% po yan. Hindi po magkakamali yan. Talagang siya talaga si Juan de la Cruz. So hindi na kinakailangan pang magkaroon pa ng distrust or scrutination na totoo ba itong data na to. Building trust and confidence to our citizen is actually the purpose of the national ID.
Thank you, Yusek Dave. Now, kung wala na po tayong mga katanungan, Yusek Dennis, you want to add?
Oh, okay.
All right. Now, this concludes our press conference. So we would like to thank our resource persons, PSA Undersecretary Dennis S. Mapa and DICT Undersecretary David Almirol Jr. Now, we extend our gratitude to other officials from DICT and PSA who are also with us today. Additionally, we thank our media partners for participating in this press conference on the national ID. We hope for your continued support and you can visit our website, psa.gov.ph, for more updates. Again, I'm Nikina Vea from the PSA. Good morning. We will be distributing